ask questions, more questions in fact than answers. And so I thought I'd structure my few comments around two questions in particular. The first is this: what does Miriam's art give us, her audience? And then the second question is, what do we, her audience, give back? So I'm imagining a dialogue, an interaction between the artworks and ourselves that's unusually active. Now, I can't speak for what you might find here, so I'm just going to tell you that for me, overwhelmingly, what I saw and felt was a reminder that we live in an imperfect world. So in Miriam's most recent work that you can see here, she appears to be expanding on that theme by asking, what is it then that makes us feel secure? What do we need to be safe and to survive in contemporary society? These are, I think, very important questions.
Of course, the person most vital to this enterprise is the artist herself. We are deeply saddened that Miriam is not able to attend this event, but it's been an honour to have worked so closely with Miriam over the last 3 years. And on her behalf, I would like to thank her many friends, family and supporters. So thanks to you. And perhaps now would be a good point to salute Miriam. So if you have a glass, please raise it to Miriam.
And what Miriam Stannage's art has, above all else, I think, is integrity. Throughout her career, she has been steadfast in her belief in the value of art, the role of art, its capacity, as I see it, to give us solace and to give us hope. And so to my second question then, what do we give back to these works, created to provoke and unsettle us? Sometimes gently and wryly, sometimes not. I'd like to suggest that what we give them is this: our attention, our respect, our pleasure, our responsiveness, and our gratitude. Thank you, Miriam Stannage. Your show is now open.